Hello everyone, welcome back to our new video. In the last few videos we were talking about financial management when we consider about the company, how we can manage the finance for the needs of the company. Now we are going to discuss this video onwards, we will be talking about financial markets, the market for finance. Market for finance. We may have heard about markets in various forms. Now we are talking about here the financial markets. Financial markets. Financial markets. What is this financial market? Before talking about the financial market, we can just have a discussion about the source of finance or the source of finance for the business. See, we are talking about the business. So, business needs finance when it needs, when the idea of starting a business, that means when the, these people who are taking an initial step in the starting of business, that means the promoters, when an idea comes in the mind of some promoters for starting the business, that time onwards, throughout the life of the business, finance is needed. And who provides? Who provides funds? We provides, the normal human being are providing the fund for that or finance for that. You will be surprising how it is possible. See, each and every person who are saving their income are helping the business in arranging the finance and utilizing that. Isn't it? Let us have one look into that. Suppose this is a house or individual home, or we can, in economic term, we will call it as household. Household will have household savings. Isn't it? In each home, there will be savings. Savings means the excess of income over the expenses. Okay? So, savings will be there even if the amount of saving increases or a high savings or amount of savings may vary. It may be a high amount of saving or meager amount of saving. Anyway, savings will be there. So these savings, what we will do, what the household will do, normally they may deposit into a bank. They will give to bank. They will deposit that into bank. And what the bank does? Bank gives loan. Normally bank gives loans to the business. Bank gives loans to business. Isn't it? Then with that money, what the bank does or what the business does? So in order to get the, that means bank, we give the money, our savings to bank. Bank gives that money into business. That is one way. Now another way, if we are thinking that no need to deposit that money into business, that bank, instead of that, we can do one thing. We can purchase some shares. Shares, you know. Isn't it? That means the company issues the capital. Capital, that means shares will be issued to collect the capital. Or to raise capital, business issues shares. We public may think that, okay, we can invest our savings into that share. Isn't it? So, what we will be doing, we may be purchasing those shares from stock exchanges. Stock exchanges. Isn't it? So, we can say that there is stock exchanges. Stock exchanges, you may be heard that the place where we can buy and sell the shares or any securities. So, we will be investing our money into stock exchanges. Isn't it? And what the business does? Business also will tries to raise the fund from stock exchange. How? We are ready to invest in the stock exchange. We are ready to buy the shares. So the money which we use to buy the shares will go to business. Sometimes we may buy shares directly from the business also. Isn't it? That means with this money, that means shareholders, that householders' savings will go either to the bank or to the stock exchange, and ultimately it will reach to business. So business also raise money from the stock exchange. Isn't it? Like that, business also raise money from bank. Is it clear? That means the shares which the business issues may be purchased by the bank also. And these shares will be purchased by the household through stock exchanges also. Is it clear? That means the money which is raised by the household will reach to the business in any way. Okay, whichever the ways may be, ultimately the money will reach to business. So that is the speciality of financial market. That is the speciality of financial market. Then now we will see that what is a financial market. What financial market says about the exchange of financial assets. That means we can say that financial market is the market for financial assets. Financial market is the market for financial assets. That is the shortest definition for financial market. It's the market for financial assets. Financial assets. We have told that we have studied various financial assets so far. We have studied about shares, then debentures, then different other instruments are there. So called money is there, then commercial bill is there, treasury bill is there, various instruments or assets are there. Various instruments are there in which we can invest money. These instruments are called assets, because asset is something where we are investing our money. Isn't it? So here we can say that these are the financial assets. Financial market is the market for dealing in financial assets. This is the market for financial assets. We can say that capital market we have told, or stock exchange we have told. It is one part of the capital market. Stock exchange is a part of capital market where we can buy and sell financial assets such as shares or debentures. Okay. So financial market is the market for financial assets. Then let us see what are the functions of financial market. What are the functions of a financial market? We are going to discuss various functions of financial market. What are the functions of financial market, or what financial market does? What helps are provided by the financial market to the business as well as to the public? First one, we can say that first important function is mobilizing savings and channelizing them into most productive uses. Mobilizing savings. Mobilizing savings and channelizing them into most productive uses. That is what the important function does done by financial market. The savings come from whom? The savings come from the household. So these savings are to be channelized to the most productive uses. What is the most productive uses? That means using these savings for multiplication. How it will multiply? Multiply
in various resources, various forms. That means the savings which we are making will go to the business. With that savings, business will produce the products and that will be sold again, and thereby again income will come. Isn't it? And not only that, the business gives employment opportunity to the people. So in various ways, these are the productive uses. Because these funds or these finance which we are using or we are saving will be multiplied. Okay. So mobilizing of the saving and channelizing them to most productive uses. That is the most important function of financial market. Another one we can say that
facilitating price discovery
helps to find out the price of the financial assets. How to find out the price or how to determine the price? Price is determined by the interaction of demand and supply. Demand and supply. Who is the supplier of finance? Household is the supplier of finance. Household supplies or individual human being supplies the finance. Their savings are supplied to the market. And that will be demanded by the business. So, where this demand and supply meets together in a particular point of price, that will be considered as the market price of that finance or the security or financial asset on that particular point. In that way, financial market helps to find out the price of financial assets, market price of the financial assets, by comparing the supply of finance and the demand for the finance. Okay. Then next we can say that the third point or third importance or function of financial market is providing liquidity to financial assets. Financial market provides liquidity to financial assets. What do you mean liquidity?
We have studied many places the term liquidity.
Liquidity means encashability, convertibility to cash or capacity to convert into cash.
So providing liquidity to what? To the financial assets.
That means share. Suppose we can consider about the case of share. You have purchased a share from a company. So that is there with you. Whenever you feel to sell it immediately you can find a seller from where, sorry, you can buy, find a buyer. If you want to sell your shares, you can find an immediate buyer for that share. From where? From the financial market. Okay. So because of the presence of financial market, we can sell our shares at any time. At the same time, we can buy the shares at any time. Immediately we can buy and sell the shares through financial market. So financial market provides liquidity to financial assets. And next one,
reducing the cost of transactions.
See, financial market reduces the cost of transactions, cost of buying and selling. Buying cost and selling cost. For example, commission or brokerage, all those things are reduced with the presence of financial market. Now, if you want to sell your share, you need to pay less than 1% or less than 25%, sorry, less than 5% of the face value of the shares or market value of the shares. That means very less, nominal amount only will be spent. That nominal amount only need to be spent for buying or selling of the financial assets. So due to the financial market, the presence of financial market, they have their rules and regulations. So as per the rules and regulation, brokers cannot charge beyond a particular percentage of commission. So in that way, It reduces the cost of transactions. So these are all the various functions performed by financial markets. Okay. Now we are discussing the classifications of financial markets. Classifications. Financial market has various segments. We can classify financial market into various categories. In broad sense, we will classify the financial markets into two categories. They are, first one, money market. And capital market. Money market and capital market. Okay. This capital market again will be classified into primary market and secondary market. Primary market and secondary market. Then this primary market and secondary market also again classify into this debt market and the equity market. Okay, market for debt capital, market for equity capital. Like that, we will classify capital market again. So anyway, this classification of capital market, we will discuss in the coming video, next video. Now we will discuss about money market. What is money market? Money market is a market for short-term securities, short-term financial assets. Money market is the market for short-term financial assets. What do you mean by short-term financial assets? That means the assets which will have a maturity of less than a year. So we can say that money market is the market for financial assets by which the maturity of those assets does not exceed 1 year. Okay. All the financial assets whose maturity period is less than 1 year are bought and sold in this money market. Okay. All the financial assets whose maturity period is less than 1 year are bought and sold in money markets. So money market is the market for short-term financial instruments of the maturity period of less than 1 year. Okay. Then who are the players in money market? Who are the players in money market? Who are the people in the, or who are the participants in the money market? We can say RBI is one of the participants. That means RBI also involved in money market transactions. Then central or state government. Then commercial banks. Then non-banking financial institutions. Okay, then households means individual, that means human being. So these are the players in the money market, or the persons transacting in the money market, or the group transacting in the money market. One more thing we can say, that mutual funds also there. That means mutual fund under, we will discuss. So RBI will be there, central government or state government, then commercial banks, non-banking financial institutions, then household and mutual funds. Mutual funds means, see, mutual fund agencies are there. For example, UTI, United Trust of India mutual fund is there. What they will do? So they collect the capital money directly from the public. That means suppose we are afraid of investing money into shares because there is chance of loss. So today we are investing money into share, and after that if the market value comes down, we may face loss. So because of the fear or because of that risk, we may not invest money into share capital. So in that case, in order to help such people, this money you can invest, those people who have the fear to invest in the capital market but interested to invest, such a people can deposit their money into any of the mutual fund agencies. They will invest this amount into some shares or debentures which are having good market value. Okay, they will have some analytical records on the basis of the analysis and all, analysis study and all, they will invest the money into shares. So they collect the money from the public to invest into shares or some other things. So that is called mutual fund. So these are the mutual fund agencies are there. RBI is there, central government or state government is there. Commercial banks, non-co-banking financial institutions, then household and mutual funds. These are all the players in the money market. Then let us see what are the instruments in money market. Instruments in money market. We have told that various financial assets are marketed in the this money market. Okay, various financial assets of the maturity period of less than 1 year are transacted or dealt in money market. So which are these financial assets which are having maturity period of less than 1 year? Which are those? So there are around 6 different types of financial instruments are there, which we are going to discuss here one by one. First one is treasury bill. Treasury bill. So, what do you mean by treasury bill? Treasury bill is the financial or short-term financial instrument issued by the Reserve Bank of India on behalf of the central government. So, whenever central government finds the need for money, that central government borrow the money from the public through Reserve Bank of India. So on behalf of the central government, Reserve Bank of India issues treasury bill. This treasury bill is otherwise called as zero coupon bond. Zero coupon bonds. Why it is called zero coupon bonds? Because it has no interest. No interest or return will not be given, or no interest will be given, or no return will be given to the holder of this other than the lump sum amount. Then how the people will purchase? On what benefit the people will purchase? There is no interest for the treasury bill. Then if there is no interest, how the or on what basis the public will purchase? Public will purchase because it will be issued at a discounted rate. It will be issued at a discounted rate. And we know that the maturity period is less than 1 year. Suppose it is issued for 6 months. Okay. Government issued a treasury bill of rupees 50,000 at rupees 48,500 for 6 months. That means you can buy treasury bill now for 48,500. After 6 months, government will give you 50,000 rupees. So 1,500 rupees will be your profit in this 6 months. Sometimes it may be issued at rupees 45,000 or 46,000 or 47,000 also. That means the difference in between, the difference in the investment, difference in the money you paid and the money you receive after the maturity is your retail. Okay, so it is called zero coupon bonds because there is no interest for the instrument. And the minimum amount of treasury bill issued by the central government is ₹25,000. So if you want to invest in treasury bill, you have to invest for a minimum of ₹25,000. That is the minimum value of a treasury bill. Okay? Is it clear? Yes. Then next one, commercial paper. What is a commercial paper? Commercial papers are issued by well-established companies. We can say that good creditworthy companies. Issued by creditworthy companies. Okay, creditworthy companies means it has good reputation and whenever it demands money, everyone will be ready to pay. That means because of the reputation or because of the resources, people believe that this company will be able to repay the money. So that belief upon the company by the investors can be called as creditworthiness. Okay, so why it is issuing? Because these commercial papers are issued at the time when the company feels a short-term demand for money. For meeting some short-term crisis. So, for a short period of time, if the company wants urgent money needs urgently, the company may issue commercial paper. Okay, instead of taking loan from commercial bank, company may issue commercial paper that has an interest. Commercial paper carries certain amount of interest. And its maturity period ranges from 15 days to 1 year. What maturity? That means commercial paper may be issued for a minimum period of 15 days. And it can be issued for a maximum period of 1 year. Within that 1 year, the money will be paid back. With the interest. Okay, that means commercial paper will be issued by the company for demanding money for a period of 15 days sometimes. After 15 days, the money will be paid back and collect back the commercial paper. Sometimes it may be for up to a period of 1 year. Within 1 year, the company will repay the money. Okay, then next we can say the third instrument. Third instrument is called money. Call money is issued by commercial banks to other commercial banks. Why commercial banks issues call money or demands call money? Actually, what it happens here is that whenever commercial banks finds some crisis of funds, this bank will call the next branch or the branch of the same bank. Okay, the branch located in another place will be called for asking some money. Okay, why there is crisis? Suppose this Reserve Bank of India insists every commercial banks to maintain certain cash reserve. Out of the total deposit received by the banks, commercial banks, a certain money must be kept as reserve with them. Okay? So because of some huge demand of loan or something like that, the bank may not be able to keep that much reserve, minimum reserve. So, in order to reach that minimum amount of reserve, company or this bank may borrow money from the other branch to meet the cash reserve ratio. So that money demanded by one commercial bank from another commercial bank is called as call money. That maturity period ranges from 1 day to 15 days. So maturity period is maturity period ranges from 1 day to 15 days. So these are all the things related to call money. That means in call money, commercial banks demands money from other branch to meet its cash reserve ratio, and this will be paid within 1 day sometimes, or for a maximum period of 15 days. Within that 15 days, the bank will repay the call money with the interest. Okay. Then let us see the next one, the fourth one. Fourth one is certificate of deposit. Certificate of deposit. Certificate of deposit is also a document issued by the commercial bank to the public, or this can be purchased by the public or any business organization or anybody. So we are depositing money into bank. Like that, bank attracts deposit. Bank asks us to deposit money. For that, the commercial bank issues a document which is called a certificate of deposit. This will also carry a rate of interest prescribed in the certificate of deposit. So if we deposit money into that certificate of deposit, that will be for less than a period of 1 year, and up to that much period we will get a percentage of interest. And this will be issued by whom? Commercial banks. And the last one we can say that, fifth one, commercial bill. Commercial bill. What is commercial bill? Commercial bills are those financial instruments issued by one business organization to others, generally for the credit purchase. Okay. Suppose two business organizations are there, A and B. A needs some raw material that A needs to buy from B. Okay, A needs to buy some raw material from B. B is the supplier of raw material. But A does not have any money to pay. At that time, what they will do? A will go and ask B, and B will say that, okay, I will pay, I will give the raw material, but you have to pay the money within 3 months. For that, I will write a bill. And you have to sign on that. Who has to sign? A has to sign on that. And within these 3 months, A has to pay money to B. Okay. So bill of exchange or commercial bill is the bill issued by the supplier of goods to the buyer of the goods for receiving the money on the sale of goods on a future date. We have studied different types of commercial bills in the 11th standard or for last year. We have studied commercial bill. We studied trade bill. We studied and accommodation bill also. We studied. That means at the time of sale of goods, we may develop some bill which is called a trade bill, or for mutual agreement on mutual agreement for arrangement of money to institution will issue commercial bill, that is called accommodation bill. So this is also having a maturity of less than 1 year. So these are all the various instruments traded in money market. Okay. So all these are there for today. So we have studied about financial market. We started from financial market and classified the functions we studied, then classified the financial market into money market and capital market. Then we studied about money market, who are the players in money market, and which are the various instruments traded in money market. That's all for today. Thank you.